Hi, I'm Brian Boyd, and I want to tell you about a very special railroad. A poorly built railroad, perhaps, and some might even say a dangerous one. It was a railroad that didn't last very long in the grand scheme of things, but while it did, what a railroad it was. And what an impact it had here in Northeast Georgia. For 54 years, the Tallulah Falls Railroad ran between the two towns of Corneila, Georgia, and Franklin, North Carolina. The old TF, as the locals called it, was a 58-mile short line, and for many of those 54 years, it was the main link to the outside world for these isolated mountain counties. The railroad's list of equipment wasn't a long one. Over its lifetime, it included 5 locomotives, 10 passenger cars, 46 freight cars, and 6 service cars. The railroad was known by several nicknames, the most complimentary being the Rabun Gap Route. But no matter what you called it, the old TF was more than simply transportation to the people of the mountains. It was a major part of everyday life in the communities along the line. It brought mail, supplies, and perhaps most importantly, the railroad brought jobs. The railroad initially reached the frontier town of Tallulah Falls in 1882 and had been extended north to Clayton by 1905. It took another 2 years to reach the end of the line in Franklin, North Carolina by 1907. The construction of the Tallulah Falls Railroad ushered in an era of tourism and lodging that was impressive even by today's standards. The economic boom that occurred brought a new way of life to the citizens of Habersham and Rabun counties and Macon County in North Carolina. The old TF played a major role in the logging industry early in the 20th century and was crucial to bringing in men and supplies to construct a vast network of dams and hydroelectric projects on the wildly isolated Tallulah River. The dams brought electricity to this rural area for the very first time. The growing city of Atlanta, just 90 miles to the south, might have developed very differently if not for the power generated at Tallulah Falls. The railroad's influence extended beyond industry as it also brought thousands of tourists into the mountains.
Almost every railroad has a mystique about it, but some have more than others. And when it comes to mystique, almost no railroad can outdo this one. The old TF was and still is one of the most beloved rail lines in the country for several reasons. The only one that comes close might be the Florida East Coast Railroad, built by Henry Flagler from Jacksonville to Key West. Like the TF, Flagler's railroad had its detractors. Back then, some called it Flagler's Folly. But also like the TF line, Flagler's Railroad opened up a beautiful but hard-to-reach part of our country. While his railroad was called Folly, the TF was nicknamed the Total Failure. But as actor Fess Parker pointed out when he was here filming the Great Locomotive Chase, you'd better be a local if you called it that.
And I'm sure you know that a lot of people joked and said it meant total failure, but it was not. The thing that we remember about the train is it was very, very slow. My mother would catch it to go visit her folks in Franklin, and she jested one time that the train was so slow that this feller give up waiting on it. He decided he'd just lay down on the track and commit suicide. Of course, she'd ask, well, what happened? And she said, well, he starved to death before the train got there.
This railroad was known for tossing candy and chewing gum to children as it passed by schoolyards and such.
And we lived in under the old Mountain City Playhouse, and I went to school at the old Mountain City Schoolhouse. And we would try to, we had to walk to school, to and from. So we would always try to get to where the time it. To whenever that train came through there. And they'd throw that there juice fruit chewing gum out to us. Back then, chewing gum was hard to get. It was a treat to get chewing gum.
But the main reason this railroad reached the status of beloved is that it opened up a part of Georgia that was otherwise almost totally closed off to the outside world. Take Clayton, for example. Andrew Jackson Ritchie, the founder of Rabun Gap Nacoochee School, said in his book, Sketches of Rabun County, that to get to Clayton, you go one day by railroad, the next day by horse and buggy, a third day on horseback, a fourth day on foot, and then on all fours until you climbed a tree. And when you fell out of that tree, you'd be in Rabun County.